Hello everyone. So my LED taillights have finally arrived. They came all the way from Romania. They're from a company called Cacciuni that specializes in making aftermarket parts, primarily headlights and taillights for cars. It took about a week to get here from GLS Couriers, as you can see, quite a sizable box it came. So I'm just going to unpackage this. We have everything we need. We got a knife. There's a box within a box. That's got it. Box has car DNA written on it. Literally, don't know if you can see it there. Car DNA. There we go. And on the back we have a photograph of my car. There we go. Don't know how well you guys can see this on camera. With Astra HGTC actually. Sorry, I'm just gonna rotate the screen to make sure I'm not missing any footage here. As you can see. So things first, I got rid of this box. Okay. I don't actually need the knife anymore, I don't think. Okay, so, alright, that's strange. When I was making the delivery, they said instructions would not be provided, and they wrote that in big red letters, and they sent me instructions in Romanian. Yep, they're in Romanian. They didn't send me English instructions. I think that's Romanian. Actually, no, it's German, sorry. They sent me German instructions. They got some English on them, but anyway. We got the taillights out of an end. Anyway, take a look at them. So take this cardboard out. Right. Oh, there we go. And we can get rid of this box. Heads here. Let's take a look at one of them. So here we have it, one of our taillights. So as you see, it's got a smoked lens, and as you can just about make out, sorry if I can get a proper grip on it, you can actually make out the red LED pattern. Sorry, it's just going in that angle. And here on the back of it, as you can see, you got the plug here. Now this here just plugs into the existing adapter. So I'm just going to take a look around these, and we'll cut over to some footage now of me fitting them in the car. First thing I should say is I'm actually going to be fitting the right taillight myself, because I just want to make sure they work and plug in properly, and then I will do a video showing you guys how to install the left taillight. Okay guys, so I have the right taillight in at the moment, so now we're going to be putting in the left one. But first off, sorry, I'm just going to show you a difference between the compartments on the right and left side of the boot. So as you can see here with the left compartment, it's very, very small. It's got a very small opening. Now there are two nuts holding in the taillights together. There's one at the top here, and then there's one down here at the bottom.
Now, this one is located all the way in here and it's very hard to get a proper grip on, so I just had to use something like a pliers to help release it. So now, as you can see, the one on the right hand side is much bigger. So it's very easy to undo these latches. If you just use even the end of a key here, you should be able to just loosen them. I think I have these loosened already. Yeah, turn it to the right. And it pops out. Now, as you can see, it doesn't set up properly. It's going to want to bounce back.
Okay, so obviously the easiest way to do this is to get in the actual boot of the car. So I've removed the parcel shelf and I just moved the seats forward a little bit to allow more room for myself. So we're going to just find the first nut, and I've got it for the top. And these ones loosen easily enough because I've already loosened them before. You only need to really have these nuts on hand tight. So I'm removing the top one. It's already loose. You just want to make sure you have a good grip on these because you don't want them to fall into the car itself. And we're just getting off the bottom one now. There you have it. Okay, so I've got that unscrewed and I have the tail light relatively loose. Just simply lets out its mountings. As you can see here, you got the cable that's holding or that's powering the lights. Just simply unhook that. Might take a minute. And there it is. And there's the old tail light out. So we'll just leave that in the boot. And here's the new one. So, as I was showing you earlier, here's the cable, and it simply plugs in place of the existing one. There you go, just clips in. So we're not going to tighten it up yet, we're just going to leave the light sitting and loose so we can do a test and make sure they work properly. Best thing to do is probably to just push the cable back into the car. So as it turns out, shortly after I told you guys you need to be sure that you don't drop any of the little white nuts, what did I do? I dropped the white nut and it fell straight into the car. It fell into around this area, I think, underneath the hollow part of the bumper. It took a few minutes to get it out with a piece of metal that was bent into a little bit of a hoop to try and yank it out. It took a few minutes anyway, but you really don't want to make that mistake. A bit of a nuisance. One recommendation is, if you are worried about dropping the nut in the whole hollow gap down here, probably a good idea maybe to stuff a towel or a cloth or something, so in case you do drop the nut, you can just easily pick it up again. So anyway, let's turn the lights on and we'll see how they look. Alright, so there you go guys. I think they look absolutely awesome, so they do. Those are just the headlights turned on there, and they just look amazing. And then you got the brake lights located just in here in that little pattern. And then they got the fog lights and reverse lights just below. So guys, I'm afraid there is one little problem that I am going to have to get resolved tomorrow, hopefully. You see, my car originally came with halogen taillights. Now, normally if one of the indicators went in the car, when I went to put the indicators on inside, they would blink a lot faster, just, you know, to warn me that one of the bulbs needs to be replaced. Now, because LEDs use less energy than the standard halogen headlights, my car has, you know, I suppose you could say, for a better term, got confused. So whenever I turn on the indicators, they flash very quickly because the car thinks that the two rear bulbs back here are not working because there's less energy being used to power them. That's all I'll now demonstrate. Now, as I showed you earlier, with the hazards on, they blink fine, but when I put them on right or left, as you can see, they blink a lot quicker. Now, this problem can be resolved with resistors, which I'm going to go to the dealership tomorrow, and hopefully they'll be able to get some, and it will just manage the power going between the taillights and the connector. As you can see, the same for the left. So, you know, this is just one of the side effects of switching from standard OEM halogen bulbs to LEDs, because obviously the car's not set up to read LED lights. But, you know, it's not a big deal. I'm going to get that fixed tomorrow, as I said, and, you know, it's just a little something to look out for. If any of you guys plan on changing, you know, your lights from original halogens to LEDs, you might want to look about getting resistors, because there's a good chance this kind of thing will happen. So other than that, I love the taillights. I think they look awesome. So let me know what you guys think, and if you have any questions regarding the taillights themselves, you know, just say so in the comments. For those of you wondering, the taillights came from a company called Kit Tuning, which are located in Romania. It took about a week to get them from Romania, specifically Bucharest, to Donegal. So guys, thanks for watching. See you again next time.